Hi guys, sort of got carried away there. I changed the angle of my turntable slightly. So you see when I turn the coin, if you're watching a previous video, you'd have seen a slight flash. And what that was, it's still not quite, but imagine I'm looking for a microscope. You're looking for the lens of a camera. So that the lens has a plane in space. Imagine that was the lens. This is a lens. So it's tilted at an angle. So it creates a distortion. So I've adjusted the angle. Say the angle of my turntable is like that. So there's a slight distortion. So I've adjusted my angle like the same, almost the same angle as the plane of the microscope. Right, I hope that it sounds perfect to me, perfectly understandable. Anyway, so just playing around with the microscope and turntable, right? I won't explain it now. You'll have to go back through my videos and look up microscope or turntable and you'll understand what I'm talking about. But this coin is clamped in a clamp in an engraving vise, and the engraving vise is on a turntable, so it slides around the top of the turntable. When you're using a microscope, probably it would help if you're not using a microscope as well, but this is important using a microscope. You adjust the turntable, so I'll put it out of rotation now, right? So I'm moving the whole table. See, so the centre of rotation will be, let me get it in view. Right, so the centre of rotation is by the neck it's a neck, it shows up. You can work it out much better on a camera for some reason than you can through the through a microscope. It's a kind of knack you have to get used to. There are things where you can locate it on the turntable, but that would mean removing what you're working on, putting a thing on, messing around. So the best thing to do is you get this knack, so you spin the turntable and you can see where the center is roughly. I mean, say it's there. So what you got to do, you got to adjust the center so it's in the center of your view. So I'll have to do that. Right, I'll do it to the microscope. Yeah, so that's in the center of my view. It doesn't actually have to be in the center. You can have the center over here, so long as you remember where it is. But mainly I found that if it's in line, so I'm looking at the screen, so let's say this is line, right? Sorry, gotta go guys. Right guys, I wasn't going to carry on, but it wouldn't be fair not to. Right, so we're talking about the center rotation. So what you do, so long as the centre rotation is in the centre of your view, it doesn't have to be exactly. I found that's okay, but you kind of just have to remember where it is. And every time, I mean, I suppose you could have everything really solidly fixed, but the way I've got it, it's kind of cramped, so I have to move stuff out of the way. So you have to kind of adjust the centre rotation if you're adjusting the focus as well, maybe. Right, so what I was just going to do, I was interested how that was coming out, that little scroll there. I was just going to, let me start again. So I'm going to put this, see, I've got to get used to it again. So where is it? Right, I'm going to adjust it slightly for my, right, so I can see it's about there for me. Yeah, right, so I'll put that scroll in the center. Slightly different now because once you start, you change. So so what I'm going to do is a set of scrolls or something from the center of rotation each time, and see what happens. Because there's no, when I do these kind of things, there's no plan. So that's why once I started cutting that scroll, it was interesting. Right, let's stop it there and say, oh yeah, let's So we're tape. So they're all individuals, right? So let's do another one over here. So, no, no. Right. So let's. Right. So as soon as I see the camera, it's always much easier to spot. So the centre is right there. Yeah. See, that's right, and that is one of the secrets, if you can call them secrets, of engraving anything really with a nice smooth curve, but particularly scroll work. So that's what you need to practice and master. So actually, this, come to think of it, this would be a, again, it's oh, it's something I coined. It's a paint the fence technique or task. So you do something kind of boring and pointless, but it'll help you doing something else, a floral scene or anything. Being able to maintain a nice smooth curve. So it's not really skill, like people might say, oh, it's so skillful. It's kind of knack and using the tools that you got, knowing how to use them, and practice. So there's something to practice. So oh yeah, so I've in just so this was an interesting one, but I've just done a, oh, let's go in a bit. Right. I've just what I call the layer style, so it's cut all the coin away in that spiral. So that would be what to do then. So let's do another one and kind of, let's do a bigger one and we'll reach it out to there. So now I'm off now, hang on. Sometimes it don't really matter, or you just, I don't know, it takes a while to warm up to the centre, but once you've got the centre, if you stay, kept it there all the time, every time would be good. So let's look at the, right, so the centre is about there. Right, so let's put this position in the centre, see if I can do it. Right, yeah, so that's in the centre. I don't think I've started. So long as it's in that location, you're right. But if you haven't got a turntable, you're trying to engrave, you probably won't have one straight away. But you'll be chasing it all over the place. You'll see that I've ordered a new one. My microscope light. I have to bang it every now and again to get it to come back on. So that's not, this spiral I'm doing now, it's not perfectly round, but it's nice and smooth. Oh, actually, once I said that, I saw a little flat spot, but it's quite rounded, and that's that's what will make something appealing. Oh, it's a bad. See that flat? Let's see if we can fix it. It don't matter. I mean, this kind of random stuff, if it's not perfect, that's how it's meant to be. Right, one more, and that's enough of that. Right, so where's the centre? I'll get the... I'm having a slight... Where I tilted the turntable, it's... it slides one way better than the other, so yes, I'm getting used to it. Oh, let's just do it there. And we'll go the other way. Oh, I'll tell you another thing, this layers style that I coined, it's quite good for, like I said, it's a painting the fence technique for carving as well. It's because you're making different layers. If you want to make a dimensional hobo nickel, then this technique would really help, because if you want something to look lifted up, you've got to cut the surface away, so that's what we're essentially doing and creating an illusion. So it only occurred to me last night. I can see how someone would hate the look of this and the thought of doing it, but kind of try and work out how you can adapt this technique. It's not the look really that I'm concerned with, it's the technique of practicing. Right, oh, let's do something while I'm at it. I just thought I just thought of something now to I was going to tell you in another video and I didn't tell you, and it's not the time to tell you anyway. It's this it's just cutting the end off. See, as I come to the end, I will tell you then. Right, I'll do another video of this as well. But when you're engraving, you'll cut a line, and then you need to break the line off. Right, you cut a line. Every time you engrave. Why is it so dingy here? Right, every time you engrave, you cut a line. Your choice is to cut the line shallower and come out, and then there's a nice smooth cut. So that's created an effect, a thin line, a thick line, and a thin line, but you might not want that. So if you want a straight line all the way, a parallel line, or a tapered line, you have to come to the end, and then you have to break the chip off. After, when you first start, you'll be breaking it, and you won't get it, and it'll be jagged bit. Don't worry about that. It's just you have to do it. After you've done it 1,000 times, you'll know how to do it. When you do a wider cut, right, let's cut, break the chip off. It's a subtle thing, see, that worked out quite well, but you see there, I broke the chip off, and nice and clean, so that's totally smooth, no sharp edges. What I found is there's two ways to break the end of the chip off. Depending what your application you got, but also the look. And the way to view the graver is not as a point all the time. All right, so the graver is pointed. Let's get that big one. When I find it. Right. Right, I'll explain what I'm gonna do. Right, although the graver is a point, it's also two chisels, let's say. So this is a chisel, this side is a chisel, and this is a side is a chisel, or a flat graver, although it is a, so it's got a point and it's got two cutting edges. When you I'll show you on this one, you can come to the end of a line, right? So this is the line we're going to come to the end to. So I'm pretending to engrave. So the graver is going along, right? You snap the point off, that leaves that kind of shaped hole. But what I'm going to do now is, and especially on a wide graver, so imagine I was doing a wide cut, the graver would be lent over. So right, so this will show up perfectly, explain perfectly. Right, so I'm cutting along, I've come to the end of the line, I lift it up, but you can see this space here is going to be left, or subtly it's going to be tiny, so it is going to break off, but you imagine it's going to break off and leave a shape. The technique that you do is you're cutting a line, you haven't finished cutting, you keep this, the point, in exactly the same place, but you carry on cutting. So you do that by turning the vise. So the graver's, I'll explain it one more time and you can play it backwards. You can rewind it and play it again, or flip it on. Right, I'm cutting a line, I've come to the end, twist the end, snap it off. You can see, if I come to that, it's just going to be a beautiful nice straight cut, and that can really make a difference to some, the look of some cuts. If you're doing feathers, I haven't worked it out yet, but so let's say we're doing, let's do a section of deep lines. Right, that's it. I'll do it another time, guys. Sorry. Cheers. Bye.